Hello, everyone, and welcome to episode 14 of the Memphis Grizzlies MyGM. And getting right into it, we started off with an injury. Seth Curry went down, and it looks like he appears to be holding his knee or his ankle, and we're going to get an injury status up on him very shortly here. But if you guys want to skip ahead to the gameplay, we will be taking on the New York Knicks today, and the gameplay is at around a minute and 37 seconds. But now we're going to get the status on Seth Curry. He started off playing good for us, and you can see that he's going to be out with a sprained left toe for about 2 weeks. So that is a quick shot to our roster, and we're going to be placing Marco Bellinelli in the starting lineup to fill in that position for Seth Curry. We also have a trade to announce. The Nuggets trade Patrick Mills for Evan Turner on the Portland Trail Blazers. A good move for the Denver Nuggets here, as they were overloaded at that guard position. And the Portland Trail Blazers get Patty Mills to back up Damian Lillard, who is definitely one of the best point guards in the league. We also did increase our GM level to 19, and I'm going to choose the one where we could reduce injuries, so all the players have a durability of +2 now. Today, we will be taking on the New York Knicks and their number one draft pick, Hakeem Christopher. You can see here, he is averaging about 12 points and 7 rebounds a game. Oddly enough, he is coming off the bench with his scoring talents and his defensive ability. And you can see here, looking at the player comparison, that he beats Jay Crowder in just about everything, and it's expected to be since he is a number one overall pick. We will be playing in Madison Square Garden, and the New York Knicks are not doing too bad themselves. They added a couple pieces in the offseason, and the addition of Hakeem Christopher should definitely make this team a potential playoff contending team. The Knicks are currently 5-3, and although it's early in the season, they have gotten out to a good start. But the Memphis Grizzlies are looking to end that here, right here in Madison Square Garden. A couple additions to this team were Jamal Crawford, of course Kristaps Porzingis is still there, and they added the former Orlando Magic center Nikolai Vucevic. David Fizdale is your New York Knicks head coach, and although Jim Wesley, the point guard out of Miami, was still on the board with the number one pick, they did not draft them and decided to go with Hakeem Christopher, loading up at that forward position. Looking at your starting lineup for the Memphis Grizzlies, we have Michael Conley, Seth Curry, who was coming off an injury, Jay Crowder, Triple J, and Mark Gasol. This should definitely be a good game for the Memphis Grizzlies and the New York Knicks. Michael Conley is also coming off a season-ending injury last year, and we're hoping that this season he could perform to his fullest and avoid any injuries along the way. Tip-off is just about underway, and here it is, the beginning of the new season. Although it is about the 6th or 7th game the Memphis Grizzlies have played, we will begin off by playing the New York Knicks. Patrick Beverley is the point guard for the Knicks. Backing down is Vucevic, trying to score on Marc Gasol. Puts up a layup attempt. That one is off the glass and off the rim, and down the other way we go with the Memphis Grizzlies. Fast break opportunity, Triple J, pull up mid-range, and that one is good, as Porzingis did not play good enough defense, and the Memphis Grizzlies are up 2-0. 4-4 is the score now. Seth Curry, quick fast break attempt, rebounded by Triple J, and put back up and in for 2 points. Make that 6-4. Patrick Beverley at the top of the key now. Michael Conley avoids the screen from Vucevic. Coming off the screen is Porzingis from Vucevic, and now the Grizzlies will switch. Now they switch back. Heading to the rim is Porzingis, trying to work on Triple J. Foul, and he gets that bucket to go, tying the game up here in the early stages, 6-6. A early foul for Jaren Jackson Jr., and you want to keep this guy out of foul trouble. One of the best shooters in the league we have so far, although his shots only come around the rim. The Grizzlies have the ball back on offense now. Patrick Beverley guarding Michael Conley. Pass given to Marc Gasol. Mid-range pull up for Marc Gasol, and that one is through the bottom of the net. Grizzlies extending the lead a bit are on another fast break opportunity, and that is Michael Conley at the free throw line, pulling up for a jumper and getting that bucket to go. The reserves are starting to come in now for the Memphis Grizzlies. Chandler Parsons gets a pass from Marshawn Brooks. Parsons now to Jermichael Green, and he throws it down with 2 hands just for safety. It is also to be noted that Hakeem Christopher has entered the game as well. 19-12 is the score with about 5:30 remaining in the first quarter. A full packed house arena in Madison Square Garden tonight. Should be a good game, most definitely. And that is Hakeem Christopher going up with the right-handed layup, and he gets that one to roll around the rim and finally falls through the bottom of the net. The Grizzlies on a fast break opportunity again, back out to Jakob Poeltl, back out to Marshawn Brooks. The Grizzlies start to get in their offense. Marco Pirlo at the top of the key. Gets a pass from Marson Brooks. Backdoor screen. Marco Bellinelli coming off the screen is Chandler Parsons. Pull up three, and that one bounces off the glass and bounces through the bottom of the net. Count that for 3 points. Grizzlies, fast break opportunity again. Euro step by Chandler Parsons over Frank Nikatina, however you say his name, and he gets the two-pointer to go. Hakeem Christopher with the forced layup attempt. Can't get that one to go, and down the other way we go with the Memphis Grizzlies. Corner, three ball, Marson Brooks ice cold, but he is starting to warm up here with that three. 12-4 run in the last 11 minutes and 3 seconds for the Memphis Grizzlies, and the score is now 31-20. Winding down the first quarter, the Knicks getting in their offense. Hakeem Christopher trying to make a move on Jermichael Green. Looks like they're going to call it ISO. Hakeem Christopher to the rim, off the glass, and can't get that one to go, and so he's going to shoot 2 free throws here. The Grizzlies found themselves in early foul trouble, and that is what kept the Knicks in the game. Hakeem Christopher at the line, shooting 2 free throws, made the first one, cutting the game down to 10 points. Let's see if he could cut it down to 9. 23 seconds remaining in the first quarter, and Hakeem Christopher definitely does that there. 9-point game at the end of the first quarter, and the Grizzlies have the lead. Let's get back onto the game now, where the Grizzlies are up by 11 points. 33-22 is the score, and the Knicks are on offense. Jamal Crawford, top of the key, gets a pick from Hakeem Christopher, now rolling to the rim. Both of them do. Forced layup attempt by Jamal Crawford, and he gets that one to go off the glass and through the bottom of the net. Grizzlies setting up in their offense. Jermichael Green gets that pass stolen by Jamal Crawford, and the Knicks have a fast break opportunity. Hakeem Christopher two-handed dunk, and he gets the foul. He's gonna head to the line, for 1 free throw, and we're gonna see if he can make it here. Christopher, free throw attempt is up, and his free throw attempt is good. The young rookie making moves early on in the game. Yogi Ferrell with a pass to Patrick Beverly, and he gets that floater attempt to go through the bottom of the net. And now all of a sudden, the Knicks are turning things around, and they are on the attack. Hakeem Christopher can't get that lip. Excuse me, he does get that shot to go. A difficult shot, and he has 9 points on 3-for-7 shooting, and he also has a rebound to add to his stat. Grizzlies in their offense. Marson Brooks trying to curl off of Marco Bellinelli to the rim. Brooks gets that tough layup to fall through the net, and that is going to extend the lead just a little bit for the Memphis Grizzlies. Grizzlies, fast break opportunity to the rim. Chandler Parsons throws up a hoop to Jakob Poeltl, and he throws it down. An unexpected play there. Great team chemistry by Chandler Parsons and Jakob Poeltl, and that is going to definitely hype up the Memphis Grizzlies and their bench. 41-35 is the score with 7 minutes remaining. Hakeem Christopher wide open underneath the basket, and he just rises up and throw that one down with one hand. An amazing dunk by Christopher, and he is definitely going to be the future of the NBA. Knicks in their offense. Kevin Knox, the third year man. Pull up mid-range, can't get that to go. Grizzlies on the break now. Guys are trailing, and they are trying to catch up. The Grizzlies are one of the fastest paced teams in the league, and you're definitely going to see that here today in this video. Marco Bellinelli wide open three-pointer, left wide open by Tim Hardaway Jr., and that is too easy of a shot for Marco Bellinelli. Starters are soon to come in as we have 5 minutes remaining in the first half. To the rim, Kevin Knox, foul and one. A tough layup for Kevin Knox, and he gets that one to go. Starters are starting to step into the game now, and Patrick Beverly steals that one from Michael Conley, and the Knicks are on a fast break opportunity, but they decide to slow it down and get it down low to Kevin Knox over Jay Crowder, and he gets that two-pointer to go. Kevin Knox misses a free throw, and the Grizzlies are on the fast break opportunity. Seth Curry mid-range, and that one is through the bottom of the net. 50-47, and the Knicks have came all the way back to potentially tie this game up. Tim Hardaway Jr. on the fast break, and he gets that layup attempt to fall through the rim. Easy two-pointer for Hardaway. Seth Curry now passes it to Triple J. Now to Mike Conley. Backdoor screen for Marc Gasol, trying to get the switch they need. But Jay Crowder, top of the key, top of the three, and that three-pointer is good and through the net. And that is going to end out halftime where the score is 55-51. A strong showing by the Memphis Grizzlies in the first quarter, but in the second quarter, the Knicks show their toughness and are down within 4 points now. 49%, 44% for these two teams respectively. getting out of halftime now. We're going to begin with the third quarter, of course, and the Memphis Grizzlies are on offense. Patrick Beverley has been playing superb defense all day, but Nikolai Vucevic is not playing that defense well as Patrick Beverley, and Marc Gasol gets that two-pointer to go. Knicks, Kevin Knox, mid-range pull-up. He gets that one to fall through the bottom of the net. Knicks on offense again. Pushing the tempo is Patrick Beverley, and he gets that pass down low to Kevin Knox. A beautiful way to just thread that ball there, and Kevin Knox has his takeover badge. Patrick Beverley gives a pass to Kristaps Porzingis. Working on Marc Gasol, he gets the foul, and he gets the and one. This Knicks team is something not to be messed with. They have stormed all the way back to take a one-point lead, and the Grizzlies must respond. Pass down low, Mike Conley can't get that layup attempt to go, gets his own rebound, and puts it back up and in over Kevin Knox. 63-63 is the score. Seth Curry, mid-range pull-up, and that one falls through the net. 65-63, and the Grizzlies take a two-point lead with about 8 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Patrick Beverley passed down low to Hakeem Christopher, and that is just way too easy for Christopher there. 13 points for Hakeem Christopher, shooting 56% in 12 minutes. An impressive showing by this rookie here in today's game. Michael Conley driving his way to the rim, and that is just way too easy of a layup, and count that for an automatic 2 points. Knicks back on offense. They are moving this ball around and on this possession, Patrick Beverley gets a pick. Heading to the rim is Beverley now. Might force up a layup attempt, and he does, and that tough layup attempt goes. The Knicks are starting to pull away now, and the Grizzlies need to respond with their reserve stepping into the game. Marson Brooks now gets a pass from Marco Bellinelli. Back out to Marco Bellinelli. Wide open three-pointer, and that one is a green release for Marco Bellinelli, tying things up 72-72. Grizzlies on the offensive side of things now. Coming off the screen is Marco Bellinelli. Driving to the rim is Bellinelli. Down low to Jakob Poeltl, and he throws it down for two hands. He gets that bucket, and he gets the foul. Grizzlies extended the lead now, but the Knicks have the ball on offense, and they are on a fast break opportunity, and that is Jamal Crawford. That ball rolls around the rim and finally falls through the bottom of the net, making the game 74-77, where the Grizzlies still have the lead. But we have another three-pointer attempt by Marco Bellinelli, and that is going to open up this lead just a bit more. A 13-4 run in the last 3 minutes and 42 seconds for the Memphis Grizzlies. Knicks trying to respond. A pick by Trey Lyles for Jamal Crawford. Back out to Frank. Oop, thrown up to Hakeem Christopher, and he throws it down, a reverse alley-oop on the baseline, and that is some crazy athleticism there by Hakeem Christopher. Pass stolen by Marson Brooks, and down the other way we go with Brooks, and he is going to throw it down with two hands, just for safety. But I'm still amazed and shocked by that alley-oop by Hakeem Christopher. That is definitely a Sports Center top 10 play. But let's get back onto the game now, where the Grizzlies are up on the New York Knicks. Patrick Beverley, three-pointer attempt, heavily contested, but that one still falls through the bottom of the rim. Winding down the third quarter, the Knicks have the ball and they are looking to score here. Frank gets a pick from Kevin Knox. Easy pick and roll for Kevin Knox, and he's going to throw that one with one hand, cutting the lead down to 5 points, and that is going to end out the third quarter between the New York Knicks and the Memphis Grizzlies. Starting off in the fourth quarter with about 9 minutes remaining, and the Memphis Grizzlies are up by 4 points. 88-84 is the score. Coming off the screen is Marson Brooks. Three-pointer attempt is up, and that three-pointer attempt is good. And the New York Knicks need a timeout in this final action of quarter. Knicks on offense. Throw a oop up to Kevin Knox. One-handed alley-oop attempt, and that one is through the rim for Kevin Knox and the New York Knicks. 91-86 is the score. Chandler Parsons, top of the three. And that one is through the bottom of the net as well. Grizzlies open it up to an 8-point lead now, and the Knicks are trying to respond themselves. Vucevic backing down, now decides to post fadeaway on Jakob Poeltl, and that one is through the bottom of the net for the New York Knicks. 94-88 is the score. 7:30 remaining in the fourth quarter. Corner three ball, Tim Hardaway Jr., and that one is good for Mr. Hardaway Jr. 94-91. inbound play for the Memphis Grizzlies. They get an inbound into Marshawn Brooks. Beautiful inbound play and a two-handed dunk by Marshawn Brooks. Just a beautiful way, a beautiful execution, and a beautiful way to score. But Kristaps Porzingis posterizes JaMychal Green. The starters are now in for the Memphis Grizzlies. Corner pass, giving to Jay Crowder. Pump fakes, trying to drive his way over Kevin Knox. Can't get that layup attempt to go. And rebounded by Knox, and he will try and push it down the other way. Knicks trying to get set up in their offense while the Grizzlies team is still recovering. Pass almost stolen by Michael Conley. Conley playing that good defense. You don't really see that by Michael Conley too often, but they kick it out to Vucevic. Conley jumping all over the place. Corner three ball, Patrick Beverley, and that one is good, and that is going to give the New York Knicks a two-point lead. Patrick Beverley step back. Nasty move on Michael Conley, but it gets denied, and he kicks it back out to Kevin Knox. Knox backing down Jay Crowder. Let's see what he'll do here. Still backing him down with about 4 seconds remaining on the shot clock. That shot attempt is up, and that shot attempt is good. Just a defeat to the Memphis Grizzlies team for playing defense on that possession. Jay Crowder, three-pointer, deep one, and that one is good, giving the Grizzlies the lead right back. A huge three-pointer by Jay Crowder, and that is going to help the Grizzlies. Blocked by Triple J. Porzingis gets it back and cuts the lead down to a two-point game. Grizzlies on offense. Michael Conley gets a pick from Marc Gasol. Gasol at the top of the key. Pass by Triple J. Gasol, three-pointer, and that one is good. 109-104 is the score. And another 11-2 run for the Memphis Grizzlies. 111-104, and that is a valiant attempt by Patrick Beverley for a three-pointer, but Kevin Knox left wide open. I'll hit a three-pointer, and the end of the game score will be 113-107, your final in Madison Square Garden. A hard-fought game by both sides. The Grizzlies showed their dominance early on in the game, but the Knicks showed their toughness and were able to come back, and take the lead. But the Grizzlies were able to hold on and reclaim the lead back, and that is how we end up with a score of 113-107. We had a great play from Jay Crowder, who hit that huge wide open three-pointer at the top of the key. That really helped us out. The leading scorers for the Knicks: Porzingis with 26, Knox with 23, and Hakeem Christopher, the rookie, with 15. The scoring leaders for the Grizzlies now: Marc Gasol, Jakob Poeltl, and Marco Bellinelli, all tied with 15 points. With just a team effort on those guys and this Memphis Grizzlies team as a whole. We shot 49%, and the difference in this game is that we made 5 more 3-pointers than the New York Knicks. We made 10, they made 5. If they would have made another 5, they definitely would have won this game. Now that the Grizzlies are victorious, let's look at the recap from around the league. Goran Dragic, Tim Hardaway Jr., and Al Horford, are a couple guys to mention that re-signed with their respective teams. The Bucks fired their head coach Mike Budenholzer and hired a new head coach called David Ham. Correction, the Bucks' new head coach is Darvin Ham, not David Ham. The Grizzlies finished with a 7-3 record in their 10-game recap, so a pretty good win-to-loss ratio there for the Memphis Grizzlies. Giannis, Kawhi, and Embiid, along with Kevin Durant, Damian Lillard, and Stephen Curry, are your players of the week for their respective teams and conferences. Now let's quickly look at the injury report from around the league this week. A lot of guys are starting to become hurt, but they aren't really any big-name guys. We had Seth Curry go down with an injury earlier, but he was able to return by the time we played the New York Knicks. DeMarcus Cousins and John Wall are a couple big names to mention on this list, and they do not have any major injuries, and they should be returning soon to their respective teams. Looking at the financial side of things, you can see in our first game, we made no profit at all. I messed up. The ticket prices were way too high, so we changed it now, and the ticket prices are now $84. So we're looking at a good profit. We're getting close to selling seats out, and our fan interest is at 100%, so I'm going to charge the fans a bit more to see the game, especially when we made the playoffs last year and we were projected to go a lottery pick. Top jersey sales: Klay Thompson is ranked 18th with the Lakers, Paul George 21st, Porzingis 22nd, and rounding out the top 25 is Rudy Gobert. 73, the Memphis Grizzlies are right behind the Warriors, who are 8-3, and they only have Stephen Curry and Kevin Durant. It's just going to be a very interesting season this year around, and we're going to see how everything shapes up here. Looking at the East now, the Toronto Raptors are 11-1 with the Boston Celtics in second place with a 9-3 record. The Miami Heat are currently 6-5 and tied for that position with the New York Knicks, while the Pacers are 6-6 and looking to move up as well. Now let's take a look at some of your top leaders. 32 points per game for Giannis Antetokounmpo, and I have been a witness to this as he dropped 51 points on the Memphis Grizzlies. The Bucks are currently 0-11, but when we played them, he was determined not to lose, and they are currently 1-11 now. Chris Paul, averaging about 13 assists per game, leading the league by a large margin there. Chris Dunn, 2.2 steals per game, with two of the Memphis Grizzlies players being in the top five. Marshawn Brooks and Mike Conley are averaging about 2 steals per game, but it is still very early on in the season, and we're going to see how that plays out here. But now let's look at our team statistics. The video is coming to an end, guys, but you could quickly check out what our players are averaging through these 10 games so far. I want to thank you guys for watching and sticking through this video if you made it this far along. And I'll be back with the next episode in about another 2 weeks or however quickly I could get the next 10 games. Peace.